We have spoken about Christianity in several of our videos, but we've never specifically spoken about the Coptic Christians. So I was very curious and I had to dive into the Coptic Christian belief system. In this episode, we're going to be looking at 10 surprising and interesting facts about Coptic Christians. Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Leroy Kenton. Welcome back to another episode of FTD Facts. And yeah, another new religion that we're going to be exploring. So I want you guys to watch this video from fact number 10 all the way down to fact number 1. This is a very interesting group here, and I don't want you to miss anything that I talk about. Okay, so let's jump right in, starting at fact number 10. Coptics were one of the earliest Christian populations in the Middle East, and they are an ethno-religious group indigenous to Northeast Africa who predominantly live in the region of modern Egypt, where they are the biggest Christian denomination in that country. Also, Coptics have a distinguished religious community in Egypt, making up roughly 10 to 20% of the population there. For fact number 9, according to Coptic tradition, Christianity was originated within present-day Egypt by Saint Mark, who was a disciple of Jesus, in Alexandria city soon after the ascension of Christ and during the reign of the Roman Emperor Claudius, and this was around the year 42 AD. Now, the impact of Saint Mark was so powerful in Egypt that it left significant Christian following in Alexandria, and it's still there to this day. Christianity spread all throughout Egypt within half a century of Saint Mark's arrival in Alexandria, as is evident from this section of the Gospel of John that was written in Coptic, which was actually discovered in Upper Egypt, and it can be dated back to the first half of the second century. Next up, let's talk about the calendar. The holy calendar of Coptic Orthodox Christianity is the Coptic calendar, also called the Alexandrine calendar, and this calendar is based on the Egyptian calendar of ancient Egypt. Now, Coptic Orthodox Christians, they celebrate Christmas on the 29th of Koyak, which corresponds to the 7th of January in the Gregorian calendar, as well as the 25th of December, and this is also known as Mariam month or month of Mary. Coptic Christmas was adopted as an official national holiday in Egypt as of the year 2002. Next thing I want to talk about is that members of the Coptic Christian Church believe both God and man play important roles in salvation. God plays a role through the sacrificial death of Jesus Christ, and the human's role is through works of merit such as fasting, charitable givings, as well as receiving the sacraments, which we're going to talk about coming up in this episode. And so fact number 6, Coptic Christians believe in baptism, confession, communion, the Trinity, the Holy Spirit, Jesus, the Bible, creed, saints and icons, and salvation, of course. And Jesus, like the other Christian groups, is perhaps the most important belief of all of them. The Coptic Orthodox Church of Alexandria believes that Christ is perfect in his divinity as well as he's perfect in his humanity. But his divinity and his humanity were actually united in one nature called the nature of the incarnate word. On that note, guys, it's the perfect time for me to let you know that we do have a playlist here on FTD Facts. This playlist is filled with different videos about religions that we've talked about before. I'll link to it below in the video description section. And if you want us to talk about a particular religion, let me know down below in the comments section. Leave your request down below and we'll be sure to explore them as soon as possible. For fact number 5, the Coptic Christian Church practices 7 sacraments, which we just talked about, as well as they practice fasting in general. Coptic fasting means following a vegan diet, staying away from meat, fish, eggs, dairy, and other animal products. And Coptics, they practice fasting 210 days out of the year. Those days are considered fast days. Another thing is that worship services within the church include traditional prayers, reading from the Bible, singing or chanting, giving donations, a sermon, and communion. So that's pretty standard worship service, not just for Coptics, but also different Christian denominations as well. For fact number 4, 1974, the Coptic Christian Church is led by His Holiness Tawadros II, born in 1952, who was consecrated by the 118th Pope of Alexandria and the Patriarch of the See of St. Mark in November of 2012. Pope Tawadros is based in Cairo, Egypt, and the Coptic Pope is not regarded as infallible or supreme, by the way. The Pope is elected by a process that is a little bit tricky and complicated to explain, but candidates must be at least 40 years old and have to have been a monk for at least 15 years. And then following the election, the names of three candidates with the most votes are written on a piece of paper, and one of them is picked by a child. So I hope that summarized properly the very complicated, long process in selecting a pope in the Coptic Christian Church. Either way, moving on to number three. Talking a little bit more about the fact that I shared earlier about Jesus, the Coptic belief which defined the church at an early stage is called monophysitism, which technically it would be better to call this miaphysitism, but most early documents, they use the former term that I mentioned. But either way, to put it simply, what this actually means is that they believe that Jesus Christ has only one nature. So yeah, we talked about this a little bit earlier, and that his divine nature and his human nature are completely united into one nature. So it's not human nature and divine nature existing together, but it's human and divine nature just bam, as one, as a new nature. This, like I mentioned earlier, is called the nature of the incarnate word, as opposed to two natures united in one person. For fact number two, the Bible is, as you would imagine, the scripture of the Coptic Church. The first translation of the Bible into Coptic script is thought to have been written around the second century, although few earlier manuscripts have survived. But Coptics believe that God and the Holy Spirit inspired men who wrote down the words of the scriptures. Speaking more about this, Pope Shenouda III also said that the Holy Bible does not mention everything. For example, not everything Christ taught was in the form of words. Much of his teaching was contained in his actions and his life. And the fact we're gonna end off on is about the Coptic calendar. Now, it's possibly the oldest in the world, being based on the calendar of the ancient Egyptians. So it has 13 months and it's divided into three seasons. There is the inundation, sowing, and the harvest. Now, the seven major feasts are the Annunciation, this is on April 7th. Also, there is the Nativity of Christ, that's January 7th. The Theophany, or Baptism of Christ, that occurs on January 19th. Palm Sunday is another important day, also the Feast of the Resurrection, and that is preceded by the Great Lent, which is 55 days and is considered by the Coptic Church as the feast. Also, there is Ascension and also Pentecost. All right, guys, so that is it for this episode. Really hope you guys enjoyed learning these 10 surprising and interesting facts about Coptic Christians. I know it was definitely eye-opening for me. It's always good learning new religions, by the way. Again, if you have any suggestions for any future videos or future religions that you want to see us talk about here on MTV Facts, let me know down below. Don't forget to check out the playlist that I have for you below in the video description section. Until next time, guys, stay awesome, stay educated, and I'll see you in another video.